Now we will learn how mobile home community owners are required to bill their tenants for utilities. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Owners of mobile home communities have regulations on how to charge and collect for electricity. Each tenant or occupant must have their own meter. The landlord must charge what's on the meter, no more, no less. Usually there is a fixed cost per month plus a charge for the usage regarding how much they used of electricity. As soon as the landlord charges the tenant for the electricity, which means the landlord puts it on the tenant's invoice, the landlord immediately owes the electricity cost whether the tenant pays or not. So what's really happening? Well, the tenant uses electricity. The landlord owes the electric company at the minute the tenant uses the electricity. So you need to put an account in the chart of accounts called electric costs payable. And that's a current liability. And that account will represent the money that the landlord owes the electric company for the usage of the tenant's electricity. So let's go ahead and add that account the way we learned. Accounting, chart of accounts, click new, and I think we decided to call it electric costs payable. So we know that this is a current liability, and the type, you know, if you want to get more specific, just leave it as other current liability and call it electric costs payable. And that will represent, if we click save and close, that will represent the money that we owe to the electric company at the moment we charge the tenant for the electricity. Now, what else is happening? Well, we have to bill the tenant. The tenant's balance goes up when we bill them for electricity. When we put the electric item on the invoice, the landlord owes the electricity to the electric company at the minute we put that item on the invoice. So the item on the invoice must be connected to the liability account we just made. So we really have to put two of them. Okay, well, look, we'll look at the example and then we'll know what item we have to put. For example, March 1, we made a new arrangement with Dave to bill him for electricity the way a mobile home community owner must do. We're charging $25 flat fee plus his current voltage, wattage, whatever, usage, and the electric company bills at 50 cents per watt, amp, volt, or whatever the usage is. So you have to put two items. You have to put a flat fee and a usage item, and they both have to be connected to the current liability, the electric costs payable. So let's go ahead and put those two items on the list. We're going to click the cog, and then we go over to the lists and go down to product and service. And of course, when we're at the items list, like we've been at several times before, we click new, and this is a service because electricity is a service. And the first item will be called electricity dash flat fee. And we know, oh, actually we could fix this with the spell check. That's nice. And we know that the account it's connected to will be the liability account we just made, electric costs payable. And of course, the flat fee will always be the same for all tenants, $25. So now we have one save and new. So now we have electric flat fee right over here on our list. But the next one should be electricity usage. I'm typing vertically here, so we use our spell check. Electricity usage. And we know that's 0.50 per unit, whether it's watt, amp, volt, or whatever they do. But that also has to be connected to the liability account, electric costs payable. When we click save and close, we can see that these two items have been added to the items list, and they will be added to the invoice when we bill the tenant for rent, and they will make the electric costs payable go up. Now, let's imagine on March 31, we read the meter and we see that Dave used 60 units of electricity. So we will add this charge to the March 31 invoice and pay, well, we will add this charge of electric usage plus flat fee to the March 31 invoice for Dave. Now, for Dave, I happen to remember that Dave pays $1,000 a month, or at least Dave would pay $1,000 a month if he actually ever paid us. But let's just pretend we're making the March 31 invoice for Dave. So we all know there are a couple of different places we could click to open the invoice window. And of course, we're going to go back and put the date March 31. Okay, and we know that the tenant is Dave. And we know first we have to charge him the rent, which is the rent due. And we know that for Dave, that's $1,000. Okay, good. But additional to that, we have to, under that item, click the pull down and choose electricity flat fee. And QuickBooks remembers that's $25. And then under that, we have to click electricity usage. And QuickBooks remembers electricity usage is 50 cents a unit. And Dave used 60 units. So he's paying $30 of electricity usage plus the $25 flat fee plus the $1,000 rent. So this invoice, if he ever pays it, is $1,055. Now, when we click save and close, we can jump over to the report and we can see for Dave that his balance increased accordingly. But more importantly, we can click reports, trial balance, and we see electric costs payable shows up for the first time as $55. That's because we added the electricity to a tenant's balance, but we ourselves have not yet paid it. So what's the end of the story? The end of the story is April 5th, we paid the electric company what we owe. Well, we all remember how to do that. You can click the plus sign, and you can click check. And of course, we're going to pay Con Edison, our electricity company out here in New York City. QuickBooks remembers it was electric expense, but this time it's only $55. But now here's the problem. It's not billable, so we have to remove the check mark. But this is not electric expense. This is not the electricity that our company used. The correct account to put is the liability account, electric costs payable. We're not paying the company's electric expense for what the company or the administration used. We're paying what we owe the electric company for what the tenant used, and the tenant will owe it to us. So after we pay from the bank account this electric cost payable, the $55 that we owe, when we click save and close, we come back to the trial balance and you can see electric costs payable has gone down to zero.